Hello, and welcome to Care Guides for Absolute Lads. On today's episode, we have the cantankerous corn snake.
Corn snakes. Everyone's heard of them. You know them, you love them, and if you don't, you may have seen one or even handled one. And if you haven't,
get out of here!
Or don't actually. Stick around. Because today I'll be explaining to you exactly the decorum associated with owning such a magnificent beast.
What's up?
This is my corn snake. His name is Apollo. He's a very sweet creature, as you can tell. Inquisitive and beautiful, among the finest of animals in my repertoire. If you're here for the care, feel free to skip to any of the time codes that I have listed right over here to speed up your journey. But if you're here for the full ride, grab your nearest charcuterie board or alternatively a juice box and enjoy the presentation. Corn snakes are some of the most cordial and friendly of all the pet snake species, and dare I say, of the pet reptile species. Being able to tolerate handling and even exploring for a substantial amount of time without getting quite stressed or tired of your presence. Jesus. I guess he's just gonna be stuck there. Their clearly, naturally inquisitive personalities makes them excellent show-and-tell animals for indoctrinating your friends, family, or captive prisoners and audiences into the cult of the reptile hobby. While the majority of snake species do tend to err more on the side of being sedentary and low activity, very obviously the corn snake is contrary to that. The crepuscular lifestyle in which it leads means it will be most active in the hours of dawn and dusk, and while handling is opportune at pretty much any hour of the day, it will remain as inquisitive, active, and docile as ever. So don't be too spooked that if you hear some rustling going on from inside your room, you need not be alarmed. It is likely just your corn snake going for a midnight jog. Being the friendly and docile creatures that they are, corn snakes are incredibly unlikely to bite out of defensiveness, but occasionally mishaps do happen. So make sure to get familiar with your snake's body language and make sure that it understands when it's being handled versus when it is being fed. Of course, your corn snake's cage setup will vary depending on its age, but generally you should follow the L rule. The cage should be roughly the size of the snake stretched head to tail from corner to corner of the cage. Here's a visual. Quite the L shape. Hatchling and baby corn snakes should be started at a minimum of a 10-gallon cage. When it outgrows that in roughly 8 months, feel free to switch it up to a 20-gallon or a 40-gallon glass aquarium. I would recommend going straight from a 10-gallon to a 40-gallon, as a 40-gallon aquarium will accommodate your corn snake for the rest of its natural life, and having to upgrade from a 20 to a 40 is just extra hassle and extra expenses that you don't want. Make sure you have the space cleared ahead of time so as not to be scrambling at the last minute. Glass terrariums are slightly expensive, but they are the easiest to come by and easiest to maintain. Additionally, they have the propensity to be the most decadent and lovely to look at of all
cage types.
Plastic tubs and wooden vivariums do work as well, so long that special care is taken to make sure that the dimensions are just right. An additional note on glass terrariums is that they do not hold heat or humidity especially well, so special care should be taken to make sure that those metrics, temperature and humidity, are upheld to only the finest of standards. As very clearly demonstrated by Apollo's sudden disappearance, don't worry, he's okay. Snakes are quite crafty escape artists.
Especially corn snakes.
Now, you might not think that your tiny, small baby corn snake would be able to, one, lift itself to the top of its enclosure, and two, be able to lift off its lid. You'd be quite wrong for thinking that. If you're using a lift-off lid, make sure to secure it with some cage clips, otherwise front-opening vivariums will do the job just fine.
Unless you like to live dangerously, of course.
Corn snakes are relatively active snakes and make it their life's work to find fascinating hiding spots. So when building a corn snake enclosure, start with the substrate. I personally use a mix of coconut core and... You are not allowed to go in there. I personally use a mix of coconut core as well as wood chips or bark, as it retains humidity the best and allows your inquisitive snake to burrow at its leisure. However, you can just use one of these items as it will be fine for your new pet, or you can use aspen substrate, but be mindful that aspen substrate doesn't look quite as decadent as coconut core and orchid bark does, and it tends to mold, and you best be sure that your corn snake will be absolutely soaking your substrate. It is possible to use topsoil or dirt to fill the bottom of your enclosure. However, keep in mind that these substrates can be incredibly dusty, and the corn snake is an animal that you will likely be handling. Never ever use pine or cedar wood as a substrate, as the intense fumes can cause respiratory illnesses in your snake, and can even be quite toxic, leading to illnesses, quite possibly death. Go crazy, go stupid, go lad, as far as decor is concerned. Go as minimalist or as maximalist as you please. Make sure to include at least two different hides on opposite ends of the enclosure to allow your snake some easy options and stimulation. Fake plants will likely work a lot better than live plants in your corn snake's enclosure, as your corn snake will tend to be relatively active, and live plants will likely be uprooted by its constant burrowing and tremendous slithering. Corn snakes are crafty creatures and will create hides out of almost anything you give them, even if your intention was for it not to be a hide. For example, underneath their water bowl, under some random substrates, or even underneath their climbing branches. Giving your snake plenty of hiding spots to choose from ensures that they are confident, comfortable, and of course, stress-free. Stress is, in fact, not so great, contrary to what many TED Talks will tell you. You can also choose to provide corn snakes with climbing branches, though they are not arboreal or tree-dwelling snakes, so height need not be emphasized. Be mindful that you don't provide hides that are too small. Corn snakes are notoriously crafty and are able to squeeze themselves into spaces that you probably wouldn't expect. Getting a very tight hide for a corn snake may sometimes mean that you will be unable to remove it if you'd like to handle it. Consider keeping your corn snake from a gradient of 60 degrees to 85 degrees, 60 degrees being the coolest it gets and 85 being the warmest. This is best achieved by having an undertank heating pad on one side of the enclosure, allowing the snake to move between hot and cold sides to thermoregulate itself. A heating pad is far superior to an overtank heating light or heating lamp, as your corn snake will likely not be very active during the day, and the heating requirements will be most advantageous during the evening and night hours. Make sure to plug your heat pad into a thermostat, as putting an unregulated heat pad directly onto the bottom of your cage will ensure that your corn snake barbecues its stomach. Feed your snake's mice, possibly chicks, but primarily mice. Your snake will take different sized mice depending on where in its lifespan it is and how large it is. The rule of thumb is to provide your snake with something that is approximately the size of the midsection of the snake, not to exceed 1.5 times its diameter. Baby corn snake can be fed pinky mice twice a week, and eventually when they outgrow that size, you can feed them fuzzies every 5 days, transitioning to hoppers and adults once a week, and anything larger than a small adult mouse can be given once every 10 days, or as needed in accordance with its activity level. Refrain from feeding live mice, as they can seriously injure your snake. Yes, it is fun to watch to see your adorable new lad absolutely eviscerate a living mouse, but it's not worth the risk of injury. Not now, not ever. You sadistic fellows. Get your frozen mice in bulk online or in stores. I would certainly recommend getting them from the websites that I have listed below. Try as best as you can to refrain buying frozen mice from Petco or PetSmart, as they majorly upcharge and you will save yourself lots of money by buying them in bulk. Make sure to fully thaw out your mice before feeding, because hey, thawing is easy. Seal your mice in a plastic bag and submerge that plastic bag into a sealed container of hot water. Let the mouse soak for about 20 to 30 minutes until fully thawed. Keep the bag and reuse it. It's gross, but much more sustainable. Also, don't fucking cook your mice, like boil them or microwave them or even hold a fucking lighter to them. It's disgusting. Just don't do it. No spit roast either. Contrary to what you will read online, feed your snake in its enclosure. Do not provide it with a secondary enclosure, as using a separate container or enclosure will require you to handle it pre and post feeding, which can be very stressful and cause regurgitation. Sometimes your snake can get cage aggressive or very food motivated, meaning they will not associate the cage opening with handling, more so they will associate it with being fed. Showing them your hand isn't food by poking them with an external object or using gloves is a very good way to tame your snake down and make sure that it doesn't attempt to make a meal out of your fingers. Shedding is a very good metric to see if your snake is in proper health. Give it its proper natural conditions, humidity-wise, stress-wise, feeding-wise, and your snake will shed its skin almost entirely in one piece. If you're seeing your snake shed in numerous different pieces, like many lizards, this could be an issue with your humidity. Corn snakes require moderate humidity, around 30 to 50%, which can be achieved quite nicely through a very moist substrate. But be careful not to keep it too moist, as an excess amount of water and other moisture can cause molding and even bacteria to spread. Additionally, the humidity helps with their respiration. As we mentioned earlier, try your best not to handle your snake after its meal, as this can cause it to throw up, which can be incredibly stressful. Additionally, if you're finding your snake regurgitating, despite you not handling it, this could be a temperature issue. Snakes and all other reptiles need warm weather and thermoregulation in order to digest their meals. If you find your snake throwing up without you inducing it, it is likely an issue with the temperature. What are you looking at? To conclude, the corn snake is quite possibly one of the handsome and easiest to take care of all the reptile species. Quite certainly one of the highest, most proliferated. The corn snake will make an excellent addition to any new or experienced pet keeper's repertoire. So what are you waiting for? It's a 10 out of 10 animal, an absolute lad. Make sure you get on the train, and I suppose I'll see you next time.
Thanks for tuning in to Care Guides for Absolute Lads. Please consider subscribing, and we'll see you lads next time.